Okay, guys, we're doing something different. I'm with my brother-in-law.
What's up?
How's it going? Is married to my sister-in-law. And we are together gonna be stripping this camper down to remodel it on the inside. Today, we're just gonna try to get everything out of it and figure out what wood needs to be replaced. I'm guessing at least some floorboards in the back here. You can see it's a little saggy. So we're gonna have to deal with that floor back there. We're gonna pull this AC out, replace it with a new window, but that's further down the line. We're gonna put some cool little taillights on there after we rewire everything. It's gonna be a whole thing. But for today, it's just the tear out, which is, if what I see on Facebook is correct, this is about as far as a lot of people get, is the tear out. Because they're all over Facebook, completely gutted, and people are just like, oh, I started the project, all you gotta do is finish it. So we're doing the easy part right now, and hopefully we will not be the people that just gut it and sell it on Facebook. Hopefully we follow through. We've got follow through, we're gonna do it. But today, we're doing the easy part. Brandon here is a master builder, so it's gonna look really good. Yeah, see, he's got two of those. He's got two drills. Like, that's the sign of a master.
Here we go.
So it should look really good when it's done. We got some good ideas, good plans. And maybe at some point we'll tell you what they are. But right now, let's see what's rotten and get this situated to where... Are we going to leave it here? Or are we going to pull it forward?
I'm just going to pull it forward.
We're going to pull it forward so that we can get out of it better. We're going to load all the stuff into Brandon's truck. And we're gonna take it way up there and put it under the carport because it takes up too much real estate to stick in a garage, and most of it's garbage. We're probably not even gonna use most of it. So that's it, let's get started. All right, the game plan has already changed. We're leaving Brandon's truck hooked up to the camper for safety and stability. And we're just gonna load into the back of my truck, which honestly is just a cooler truck. It looks better hauling stuff to the carport, so aesthetically it's the better choice. Brandon's truck is kind of a newer piece of shit model, and so I mean, I probably the better choice. So here we go. Well I guess here I'll give you the tour. It shouldn't be that hard. There's the tour. We got seating area. We got some old homemade cabinet stuff. You know, there used to be a toilet in here. We decided, because there's a window and a drain in the floor. There's some pretty sweet bunk beds over here. And then this pretty giant cabinet right here. So we have some layout designs that we're gonna go with that we came up with in our heads the other day. But we're gonna tear all this out right now. Right down to the studs and floors, and here it goes. Got quite a bit out. We've learned some stuff. We think maybe there used to be a kitchenette or something on this side, because we've got this vent, which we knew we saw from the roof, and it was covered by the work they had here. And definitely, I don't know if you can see up in there, all those wasp nests. We've only found one. We found one live one, which resulted in the explosion of a fly swatter.
Oh.
seen that.
That is strong.
You need to market that and be like,
that was one strong wasp.
Wow.
Jesus Christ.
That was like the Iron Man, Superman of wasps, dude.
That was like, 3 years old, dry rot.
I mean, it, I wish I had it on video. It was very funny.
It's like a fireworks.
And so we're coming along. That's the check-in. And here we go. We're doing other stuff.
Yeah, cause
so we got.
Wait, no, we have to reenact.
Okay.
Yeah, that wheel well really messed my plans up. I wanted to put the cooler right there.
Damn it,
and
bro.
And we're really gonna have to do a hard curve around that if we want it to look like how we discussed earlier.
So I'm thinking, if we come over with a box, we can do the box out from here, here. If the depth of the cabinets are here, the bookcase.
The bookshelf, yeah.
This could just be a box that basically rides the whole top with that curve that would come in to wrap here, or we could do, you know what I'm saying, something like this. So the bookcase will sit on top of this box.
Because, I mean, I'm talking pretty shallow for the bookshelf, like yeah. small books and right. spices and yeah. just, you know, random knick-knacky Instagram-y stuff.
Right.
And then come out to, and pretty shallow too, but also I don't want to waste space. I don't know, because we were talking about from right here doing, well, I mean, even lower, because it's going to have to be for the bed, the night shelf
right
kind of thing, and then the same thing up here over the window.
All right, so we could do this too. We could bring,
we want to make it
also for non-practical bougie Instagram pics.
Exactly.
This would be a writing desk.
Exactly. Maybe with a pop-out chair that goes under the
something,
bed.
Dude, something, dude. I'm telling you, like, you could make this super bougie. You got your book out. You open it up.
A custom chair that links into the bed.
You know what? I don't.
You know we're going.
You're bad. You're going so crazy right now.
And maybe something
that elevates from the floor.
Like yeah, like a foot pump.
Yeah.
No, a chair that has like that angled seat where you can just sit like this.
Oh wow! Yeah. That way, if you have to go immediately, you're already
right.
halfway in
right.
position.
It's
so you're just
perfect.
Like, you're just like, oh, I got a hike.
It's the perfect, dude. I think half standing stepper desk. You know, like the mm-hmm. jogging desk. So you mm-hmm. have a half step, but you're also on a stepper. So you just keep.
What do they call it whenever like the runners get ready to run and they're like in a kneel forward position?
I don't
know.
You
can do a desk like this too, where you're literally yeah.
Man,
we got a lot of potential here.
Yeah.
This is a birthplace of new ideas.
He's struggling. He's about to decide that he needs to use a screwdriver.
The hammer. Yeah, she's locked in.
Locked.
Bro,
no hammers. We need to preserve that pristine original flooring.
Got it.
Okay, so in its previous ownership, wood and new floor seems to have been put over the original, which is gonna gain us 3/4 of an inch. Of headroom, which is nice because I am 6'4". And then
size.
We're also gonna maybe think about raising the roof a little bit too, but we might actually be able to get me enough headroom in here, which is nice. What do you think, bro?
Be great. You're extra large.
Jurassic shirt. You're really representing right now.
Yeah, dude.
This is Jack. What's up, bro? You hurt your hand?
Yeah, we're here.
You're good.
Where? Show it to the camera.
Here.
Oh, you talking about that little scratch?
Yeah, that.
I told you to be careful, dude. Yeah. It's okay. You're okay?
Yeah, do you want to play hide and seek?
Oh, we're still doing stuff, dude. We're still busy. We're gonna play. We're gonna play. I promise you, we're gonna play. Anyway, back to work. Okay, we finally got to the worrisome spot that we were worried about.
That we knew about.
Yeah, we knew about this.
It was gonna be bad.
But,
There she is, bud.
There she is. She's looking right knackered.
Sent her a little hard, bud.
Right knackered. It's really not that bad. This is the portion. So this is why it fell through right here. Is this is a main support beam right here. And it's just sitting here loose. So that's why that back corner sunk in. But I don't think it'll be that hard to fix. We do have to figure out where the leak was coming from. It looks like possibly the window, but also
to the walls, yeah, possibly as well.
No, yeah, we got moisture up in here for sure. So probably that. I wonder if they re-caulked that seam. Let's go check that seam out there and see if they did. I know I saw some, definitely some aftermarket caulk. And yeah, I don't see any on this back edge though. I bet that's where it was coming in. Hell, you can see the gap.
Yeah.
Yeah, you can see the gappage out here. They got a little bit on this right here, but up on this top one, they don't have anything. So I bet that's where most of that water was dripping in. It's weird that they didn't just go all the way up.
No, man.
Like they got it. And this, I mean, it's so obvious.
Nah, dude, that's what half-assing's all about.
But I mean, they put way too much caulk on the lower portion.
To hold it all in.
It's so weird. People, man, previous owner shit. I'm the previous owner usually, but in this case.
Not this time.
Not this time. I'm the new owner. Anyways, so yeah, I don't think it'll be that big a deal. We'll have to get out here one day with some jacks and figure out how to lift kind of this whole back corner up to shore up this side. We'll have to take this whole trim off and this whole outer piece, which doesn't look like it'll be that much, just a bunch of screws, lots of screws. And then we'll do some rigging and jigging.
Jacking and racking.
That's a fun Saturday night. Anyways, we're gonna get back to work. Okay, Brandon's peeing, and we got a lot done. So one problem that we're having is that the way these things were put together, the roof skin, the interior skin, is sandwiched between the frames. So we're thinking they made the walls, they framed the walls and then like laid the roof on top of it. So we're gonna have to roto zip around the whole thing. But I gotta dip out. Brandon, I think, might keep working, and we'll see how far he gets next time I come over here, which will probably be another week or so. I don't know how much he's gonna work on it while I'm gone, but we got, you know, your basic rot around your vents. That, I mean, somebody added that. That doesn't look, it's the door's blocking it right now. I don't know what that was added for. But anyways, yeah, we're just gonna get to work replacing all the rotted parts of the frame, which really, honestly, it's not a lot. I mean, it's a couple hours of framework, I think, if that. And then we'll be ready to get to interior design concepts. So I guess that's it for this one. Keep following. I guess if you're interested to see how this turns out, I think it's gonna be pretty freaking awesome. And then when we're done, you can rent it if you want, because I think that's the plan, is to rent it out to people. where we live. So that's it. Bye.